Please all rise for the angelus and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good evening. We welcome you as we celebrate the Holy Eucharist, Monday of the 12th week in Ordinary Time. We are also celebrating the memorial of St. John Fisher and St. Thomas More, martyrs. St. John Fisher, a bishop, and St. Thomas More, Chancellor of England, were beheaded for disproving King Henry VIII's divorce and remarriage and the establishment of the Church of England, headed by the King. Our presider for this evening is Father Baltazar Obico, OFM.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the memorial of two martyrs, St. John Fisher, Thomas More, both were beheaded because of their strong stance about the sanctity of marriage against the wishes of the King Henry. Let's then pause for a moment and humbly acknowledge our need for God's mercy and forgiveness. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in the martyrdom have brought true faith to its highest expression, graciously grant that strengthened to the intercession of Saints John Fisher and Thomas More, we may confirm by the witness of our life the faith we profess with our lips to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the second book of Kings. Shalmaneser, king of Assyria, occupied the whole land and attacked Samaria, which he besieged for 3 years. In the 9th year of Hoshea, king of Israel, the king of Assyria took Samaria and deported the children of Israel to Assyria, setting them in Hala at the harbor, a river of Gozan, and the cities of the Medes. This came about because the children of Israel sinned against the Lord their God, who had brought them up from the land of Egypt, from under the domination of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and because they venerated other gods. They followed the rites of the nations, whom the Lord had cleared out of the way of the children of Israel and the kings of Israel whom they set up. And though the Lord warned Israel and Judah by every prophet and seer, "Give up your evil ways and keep my commandments and statutes in accordance with the entire law which I enjoined on your fathers and which I sent you by my servants, the prophets," they did not listen, but were as stiff-necked as their fathers, who had not believed in the Lord their God. They rejected his statutes, the covenant which he had made with their fathers, and the warnings which he had given them, till in his great anger against Israel, the Lord put them away out of his sight. Only the tribe of Judah was left. The word of the Lord. For our responsorial psalm, our response will be, "Help us with your right hand, O Lord, and answer us." O God, you have rejected us and broken our defenses. You have been angry. Rally us. You have rocked the country and split it open. Repair the cracks in it, for it is tottering. You have made your people feel hardships. You have given us stupefying wine.
Help us with your right hand, O Lord, and answer us.
Have not you, O God, rejected us, so that you go not forth, O God, with our armies? Give us aid against the foe, for worthless is the help of man.
Help us with your right hand, O Lord, and answer us.
To honor the gospel, please rise. Alleluia, alleluia. The word of God is living and effective, able to discern reflections and thoughts of the heart. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Stop judging, that you may not be judged. For as you judge, so will you be judged. The measure with which you measure will be measured out to you. Why do you notice the splinter in your brother's eye, but do not perceive the wooden beam in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, 'Let me remove the splinter from your eye,' while the wooden beam is in your own eye? You hypocrite, remove the wooden beam from your eye first. Then you will see clearly to remove the splinter from your brother's eye." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the dangers of someone trying to be a devout follower of Jesus, especially those who are religiously observing rites and rituals, is to believe in one's righteousness. Deluging oneself to be self-righteous leads one to spot the shortcomings and weaknesses of others. Such an attitude is psychologically fulfilling as it sets us apart from others whom we consider rashly as not living faithful lives. In other words, we can easily be judgmental of other people. This is the same danger that Jesus anticipated for his followers. We take note that today's gospel is the start of Matthew 7. We have already finished reflecting for a couple of weeks Matthew 5 and 6, the Sermon of the Mount, where Jesus is portrayed by Matthew as the new Moses, the new lawgiver. In this Sermon on the Mount, Matthew 5 and 6, Jesus gave his disciples the radical, stringent demands of his teaching. And these disciples may take themselves as a people set apart because they have already their own scale of values and the certitude of communion with God and Jesus. These might, like the Pharisee, separate them from others and judge others with severity. Today's gospel, the will of Christ is unequivocal. When a man judges, he is adopting a value system which discovers a beam in his neighbor while having a plank on his own. Jesus uses a satire, if not a hyperbole, to emphasize the point. Para pong sa Tagalog, to see the exaggeration and make it a caricature, sabi ni Jesucristo, may puwing so dust, so tiny ang iyong kapwa. Pero makikita mo ito at nakikita mo ba ito kung ang nakahalang sa iyong mata ay troso? To stress the seeming impossibility of we judging our fellow men. Why? Because we know that we have inherent deficiencies. A good example would be our biases. Our anger can distort our evaluation of other people. But more than that, what we can judge only and see are external acts. We cannot fathom the interior motives from which these acts sprang forth. But most importantly, judgment is a divine prerogative which we cannot appropriate nor arrogate, because to judge means or it implies that you are saying that this individual is not fit or fit to live. When we judge, actually, we play like gods. So this gospel, therefore, invites us to see ourselves as sharing the same vulnerability with the rest of our fellow men. That means it invites us to give up the power game we used to play, playing innocent versus the guilty. That the shortcomings and weaknesses of others, instead of leading us to judgment, should instead lead us to see the very same weakness which we spot on others. Let us now pray to our merciful Father that we may be generous and charitable in our opinion of others. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That the Church may fulfill her ministry of healing and forgiveness, let us pray to the Lord. That government officials may show care and concern for the poor and the marginalized, let us pray to the Lord. That we may be able to see our own faults and refrain from passing judgment on the failures of others, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, teach us your mercy.
That the sick, the lonely, and the handicapped may find strength and healing, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, teach us your mercy.
That the COVID-19 epidemic come to a swift resolution with the recovery of the sick, the protection of those who have been exposed, for experts to find a cure, for government and health authorities to take the appropriate steps to halt its spread, and that we, the faithful, act responsibly for the good of all, we pray.
Father, teach us your mercy.
That our dear departed relatives and friends may find peace and eternal joy, let us pray to the Lord.
Father, teach us your mercy.
And in the silence of our hearts, we offer our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, teach us your mercy. Merciful Father, these prayers and intentions we bring before you express our needs and hopes. We ask you these through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
Pray, my dear friends, that is your offerings be made acceptable to God, the loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with serenity and kindness, we pray, O Lord, upon these present offerings, that they may fill with the blessing of the Holy Spirit and may stir up in our hearts that powerful love, to which the holy martyrs John and Thomas overcame with bodily torment, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
Truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith. To their endurance you grant firm resolve. In their struggle the victory is yours, through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth, sing a new song in adoration. And we, with all the host of angels, cry out, and without end, we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave you thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Father, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Roderick, our administrator, and all the clergy, remember also brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with Blessed Apostles, with all the saints and martyrs, John and Thomas, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us greet one another now, the sign of peace. Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, behold him, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited to partake of this supper.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Renewed by the sustenance of the one bread, O Lord, and the commemoration of blessed martyrs John and Thomas, we humbly pray that you may confirm us ever in your charity and make us walk in newness of life through Christ the Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Her Majesty's ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Please join us for the intercessory prayer to Saint Francis in time of necessity. Saint Francis, through your intercession, we seek to develop in ourselves the faith, hope, and love that moved you to joyfully and radically follow our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we can see the meaning and the invitations of this suffering that befell the world today, the continuous spread of the pandemic coronavirus that makes us worried and anxious. What will happen to us, especially that the poor would suffer gravely? Help us to put our trust fully into the loving hands of God. May we receive the inner strength to overcome our most pressing concerns today. In this present calamity, may we open more generously our heart to share to the poor as offering to God, hoping that this be the start of our personal conversion and the transformation of the church. Saint Francis, help us to continue praying for the grace of protection from this virus and for our deeper faith in the love and mercy of God. May the blessings that we will receive through your intercession deepen our faith and inspire us to store up treasures in heaven, where we hope to spend eternity with our loving Father. May we learn to pray as you've prayed, and pray with faith, sincerity, and conviction. Where there is charity and wisdom, there is neither fear nor ignorance. Where there is patience and humility, there is neither anger nor disturbance. Where there is joy in acceptance, there is a desire to be proactive and trustful. Where there is inner peace and meditation, there is neither anxiousness or dissipation. Where there is love of the Lord, there is no doubt and the enemy could never enter our hearts. Where there is mercy and discernment, there is neither excess nor hardness of heart. Pray for us, Saint Francis, that we may obtain the graces and favors we ask for, especially that we may obtain the grace of deeper faith in the triune God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.